I remember when I was deciding to leave my teaching job at the high school level. So that was like a full-time job. I had been there a long time. I had a good reputation. You know, everybody knew me. It was a small school. And I remember my teacher friends saying, you know, how can you give up your salary? How can you give up your retirement? How can you give up everything you've sunk in? Not to mention the two master's degrees I have, right? Not to mention the years of lesson plans I've created. So I think that it's really easy to ignore the tap on your shoulder because you've got so many sunk costs already. And you know how to navigate the problems. And then it's a really hard conversation with yourself to have to say, is this really so bad that I'm willing to give up all of those, you know, all of those things I've already done and accomplished and achieved for something I have no idea what's next? And I didn't. I did not know what was next. But that inner voice, that little intuition that was like tapping on my every time I would take a shower before class, I'd be thinking about, can I just cancel today? That's like a big red flag for me.
Yeah. And I think that sunk cost fallacy is one that stops a lot of us from making progress. And so I love that you brought that up because we feel like, well, I'm already this far in. I guess I better keep going.
Exactly. Do you know how much getting those two master's degrees cost me? Right. Like, of course.
And I suspect as we hear about what you're doing now, those two masters are serving you in new ways.
They are. And I was going to talk about that, but I didn't think they ever would serve me again. So I have a master's degree in teaching, specifically English, seven through 12. And then I have another degree in adult literacy. And I just never thought, where are these going to ever come in again? I'm going to fast forward. We can go back and dabble, but to fast forward to where I am now, I basically teach experts how to kind of harness their brilliance and harness their language so that their audience can hear them.